Hi, my name is Sarah Guffels, and I lead DevRel here at Sentry. This is the next video in the Debugging Your Next.js Projects with Sentry. And in this video, we're going to talk about alerts. Before we jump into alerts, I want to talk a little bit about our integrations. If you head into your organization settings, you can find various integrations that may or may not be useful for your team. We have the GitHub integration installed here, and that's the only one we have installed for this demo right now. The GitHub integration essentially authorizes Sentry to augment any issues with commit data and allows us to trace any errors to the actual line of code within your GitHub repository in stack traces. We saw this in one of the previous videos that we had in this video series. One of the really useful features about the GitHub integration is the use of the code owners file, which allows you to assign issues automatically to the code owner of the file where the stack traces identifying the issue came from. Lazar is the person who set up this GitHub integration, and we can see that he connected up this specific repository with our Sentry organization. We can see that this repository is actually set up with various projects across our Sentry organization, and that we have specified what our GitHub usernames are and which GitHub username is associated with which Sentry user, so that we can leverage the code owners file that you'll find in the GitHub repository with our issue assignments and automatic alerts. You can find the GitHub file over in the repository under .github/codeowners, and you can see here that anything regarding flashcards, Lazar is the owner, and anything regarding categories, I am the owner. So we know that we can leverage code owners. Let's see how. We're going to go back into our project settings, and we're going to head over to ownership rules, and we're going to click on import code owners. We can choose to apply an existing code mapping, which is the one that is found associated with the flashcards repository. This is because Lazar already configured the GitHub integration to be able to access that repository, so we can just use that same configuration. Now you can see in Sentry that from the code owners file, we received this rule right here, which says that anything regarding flashcards, the owner is Lazar, and anything regarding categories, the owner is me. You'll also notice that the owners are Sentry users, not GitHub usernames, and that's because we do have those user mappings that we just saw. From here, we can head back into our project dashboard, and we can trigger another event and hopefully see that Lazar gets automatically assigned to that event. Let's head back over and refresh this page, cause another error to happen, update. Notice that the error gets caught in the JavaScript console. Head back over to the project, open all of our issues, and we'll see that a fifth error has happened, and now the assignee is automatically set to Lazar. That's great, and maybe he has his own alert set up, but let's also talk about setting up alerts. Back in our project dashboard, we can either click here at the very top, or right here, create alert to create a new alert. You can see that your alerts can be dependent on a number of things. It could be dependent on a new issue getting created, the number of errors that are showing up in a particular issue, the number of users experiencing those errors. It could also be based specifically on sessions, or you can have alerts based on some kind of performance issue. You can also create a custom measurement that an alert can be based on. In this case, we really only have one issue type, and so we're going to base this off of the number of errors that are showing up within that issue type. We'll set some additional conditions for this error to be triggered because we don't necessarily want it to just be triggered every time a new event happens within that issue. We're going to set this to a 1 minute interval because this is a video that I don't want to be an hour long while we just sit here and wait. It'll be specifically for this project, for all environments, and of event type error. You can change this to be just development environment, just production environment, or to have additional types of events happening, but for this scenario, we just want to do errors. Again, this is a very simple demo, so I'm going to change these defaults to something a little bit more manageable. It's going to be a critical alert if we get more than 5 errors happening associated with a single issue. So we noticed that already with our current issue does have exactly 5. So it should trigger kind of a critical alert to Lazad if we were to trigger it again. We can set the warning to 3 and we can just set the resolved to 0. So if no new events happen, then it's just resolved. Then we can add an action. For a critical status, we can send an email to a member, and in this case, we can choose what the member, who the member might be. You can also send it to an entire team, so you can make sure that your team is set up inside of your organization and send it to everyone there. Let's go ahead and send it to me. If you had additional integration set up, like Slack or Teams or Discord, then you can have alerts go through there as well. We're going to name this issue. I named it Something is Wrong. You probably want to have a slightly better name than that. And the ownership is going to be for this organization, which is our DevRel org. We'll save the rule. And so far, we haven't had any alerts triggered at this time. But if we were to trigger the error one more time, we would see that I get this email sent directly to my inbox, since that's the alert that we set up. In the next couple videos, Lazad will actually be going through some more advanced Sentry features, such as session replay and distributed tracing, so stay tuned for those.